Hello mga kamikmi, Kuya Mo Felix, back at it again with another lecture, and for today's lesson, tuturuan ko kayo kung paano kumuha ng orthogonal trajectories and konting background and konting lecture tayo bago tayo mag-proceed sa example. So without further ado, let's start. So konting lectures lang muna tayo with respect sa orthogonal trajectories. Pag sinabi mong orthogonal trajectories, ito yung one of the many applications ng first order differential equations, no? And pag sinabi natin orthogonal trajectories, related to sa family of curves, no? So sana no nakapag-review with respect sa family of curves and analytic geometry, no, related dito, especially yung ating conic sections, no. Matunog na matunog ditong gamitin yung conic sections natin. So before we start, pag sinabi natin trajectorials, these are family of curves na nag-pass through sa certain family of curves then. So for example, I have a certain family of curves such as this one. Let's say that is f of x, no? This is f of x, and this f of x is a certain family of curves. Now let's say something, f of x is equal to something plus ano, plus c, kasi ano to, no? Let's say something plus x. Yan. For example lang, for example, x plus c. This is the family of curves na related sa ito. Pag sinabi nating orthogonal trajectories, dapat may isa pa tayong family of curves passing through or cutting to each and every point ng family of curves na to 90 degrees or orthogonally, perpendicularly. And this is our g of x is equal to, let's say, hindi ko sure, no, this is just an example, no, for demonstration only, no. So inconsistent yung mga functions na yan, this is just for demonstration. So ibig sabihin nito guys, if we have a certain family of curves such as this one in black, the orthogonal trajectory is the one in red, or these are the curves that perpendicularly passes through each and every curve nung family of curves natin. Ngayon, in order for us to solve, first, kailangan natin makuha yung, ito yung step one, no? First is get the dy over dx ng function. Okay? Kung kailangan mo muna ng dy over dx yung function. Bakit? Going back to algebra, or algebra, going back to analytic geometry, no? Or in terms of lines, di ba? Before, if we speak about dy over dx, that is equal to the slope of the line. Okay? And kapag sinabi natin slope of the line, that is equal to a over b. Okay? Now, if we want to get the orthogonal trajectory, we need to get the perpendicular lines, no? Parang we need to get the perpendicular curves with respect to this particular curve. So for example, if this is our a over b slope, di ba ang orthogonal or ang 90 degrees ng a over b is based dati, no, sa analytic geometry, that is negative b over a or negative reciprocal. That is your perpendicular slope, di ba? So, ibig sabihin, this will be our new dy over dx or the orthogonal, or for our orthogonal trajectory, ito yung gagamitin natin dy over dx. Okay? So, basically, ito yung kailangan natin tandaan. Okay? Step one is to differentiate yung given na family of curve. Then, you need to get the negative reciprocal of it. And after that, kailangan mo ulit i-integrate back yan para makuha mo naman na yung ating family of curves. Okay? So para mas magets natin, definitely, kailangan, let's have some examples. Okay, for our example number one, para lang magets lang natin kung ano bang ibig sabihin ng orthogonal trajectories, let's have a basic example. Let's solve for the orthogonal trajectory of this family of curve. And speaking of family of curves, ano bang family of curves itong nakikita natin? If I'm going to illustrate this, so drawing ko siya, no? If I'm going to draw this, ang pangit, teka, snappy, yeah, gawin natin snappy. So if I'm going to illustrate this, ganito yung tsura niya, no? So this is the family of curves at center at origin, no? Na ang radius is equal to square root of c, no? So parang ganito yung tsura niya pag i-graph natin, no? Yan. Ganyan itsura niyan. So hindi, medyo hindi consistent. Yan, parang ganyan siya, no? So this is the family of curves, yan. Yan. Okay? Now, our goal is to find the orthogonal trajectory or the family of curves na always passing to these curves at 90 degrees kasi nga orthogonal. So first step, no, step 1, again, step 1 is to differentiate. Okay, so i-differentiate natin si x square plus y square is equal to c. Kasi nga ang goal natin is makuha yung dy over dx, di ba? So this will become 2x dx plus 2y dy is equal to 0. Kasi di ba ang differentiate, ang derivative ng constant is 0. So we can cancel 2, we can cancel 2. So therefore, x dx plus y dy is equal to 0. Okay? And ang goal natin is magkaroon ng dy over dx. So manipulate natin. So this will become negative x dx all over y. And this is all over y then. And kailangan mawala yung dx dyan, over dx, kaya may over dx dito. Kaya kung mapapansin nyo, parang nag-cross multiply ka lang basically dyan, dy over dx is equal to negative x over y. And this is the slope, no? Parang ito yung slope ng ating family of curves. So this is dy over dx. Now, ang goal kasi natin is makuha yung dy over dx ng orthogonal. So ang gagawin natin dito is step 2, get the negative reciprocal. And the negative reciprocal of negative x over y is just y over x. Okay? And after that, so ito na yung orthogonal. Parang ito na yung ibig sabihin nito, yung orthogonal slopes natin, or these are the 90 degrees with respect to the given family of curves or yung circle kanina. So ang step 3 natin is, step 3 is get the solution. Anong get the solution? Ibig sabihin guys, i-integrate natin siya, or we need to get the general solution of this particular DE. Kaya nga, di ba, ang dami nating methods of getting the solution. So, magagamit natin yun using this. So, pwede natin gawin dito is, as you can see, if ang ating kailangang hanapan ng solution is y over x, you can see that I can cross-multiply it again. No? Magiging dy over y is equal to dx over x. And upon checking, no, pasok to sa variable separable. This is already variable separable, no? So what I can do is just integrate. And ano mangyayari dyan? This will become ln y is equal to ln x. And don't forget, dapat may c. At ang gagawin ko dito, hindi lang basta c, no? Gawin ko lang ln c din. Kasi puro ln, eh, para madaling i-simplify later. So ang mangyayari dito is, I'm gonna simplify this, no? Pwede ko itong gawing ln y is equal to ln xc. Okay? So, pag ni-raise to e mo yan, no? Ang mangyayari dyan is, parang nag-cancel ka dito, no? Basically, hindi naman talaga ganun yung operation, pero ganun yung sense, okay? Using laws of logarithm. So, that is y is equal to xc. Or, rewriting this, guys, this is equal to y is equal to cx. And this is the orthogonal trajectories of the family of curves ng circle. And kung papansin nyo, guys, anong family of curves to with respect sa analytic geometry? Eh, di ba this is the family of curve for lines? So if I'm going to demonstrate this, or illustrate rather, or graph, yung y is equal to cx, this is lines passing through the origin, di ba? At different slopes. So parang ganito itsura niyan. Yan, no? Pak. 1, 2, 3. And kung mapapansin nyo, if this is our initial family of curves, no, which is sitting x squared plus y squared is equal to c, the orthogonal trajectory of families of circle with respect sa origin is, at the center is origin, is lines passing through the origin then where y is equal to cx. Bakit ba siya orthogonal trajectories? Kasi kung papansin nyo guys, this is 90 degrees. So lahat dapat ng family of curves na it ikakat niya or itra-traject niya is equal, is dapat with respect sa 90 degrees. And that's how orthogonal trajectory works. Okay? Gets? Okay, let's have some examples pa. Eto, example number 2. Kunin naman natin ang orthogonal trajectories ng lines. Kasi kanina, di ba, ang nakuha natin is with respect sa circle. Ano naman kaya ang orthogonal trajectories ng lines passing through the origin? Kasi passing through the origin ang ibig sabihin yan, eh. So first, anong gagawin nga natin? Differentiate muna natin. Y is equal to cx. Differentiate first. That is dy is equal to c dx. Okay? Kaso, medyo may konting problema tayo dito. pag ginawa kasi natin yung dy over dx that is equal to c, di ba? Kailangan mo ng value ng c. Saan ka pwede kumuha niyan? Since, di ba, kung naalala niyo yung elimination of arbitrary constant, mas maganda sana kung ma-eliminate yung constant. Kaso, since this is just first order applications, edi hanggang dy over dx lang tayo, no? Yung raise, isang basis lang nag-differentiate kasi first order. And basically, pwede akong kumuha ng c with respect dun sa given. Kasi di ba, yung c mo, that is equal to y over x. Di ba? Pag minanipulate mo yan. So therefore, I can rewrite this now as dy over dx is equal to y over x. Okay? So if I want to get my orthogonal, no, orthogonal slope, for example, that is equal to negative x over y. Okay? And after getting that, eh, kunin na natin yung general solution with respect to this orthogonal slope. So that is equal to distribute lang natin, no? So for example, sulit ko lang ulit dito, dx which is equal to negative x over y. So pag dinistribute mo lang yan, magiging y dy is equal to negative x dx. So this is just variable separable na, no? Pwede mo nang i-integrate yan or in, on its own. So this will become y squared over 2 is equal to negative x squared over 2 plus c over 2. Gawan ko ng over 2, no? Para pag nag-multiply ako ng 2, eh mag-cancel out lahat ng 2. So basically, my answer is just y squared is equal to negative x squared plus c. Simplifying everything or transposing para mas magandang tingnan, y squared is equal to c. And that is your orthogonal trajectory. So, ibig sabihin pala guys, ang orthogonal trajectories ng lines passing through the origin is also circle, origin at zero. So, ibig sabihin, pag sinabi natin orthogonal trajectories guys, vice versa, siya din yung ka-orthogonal trajectory niya. So, ibig sabihin, if this line, ito, if this line, yan yung family of curves natin, yung line na to, yung orthogonal trajectories niya with respect to it is circles din at the origin. Ayan. Gets, ayan, no? Kunyari, ito, with respect dyan. Ito yung mag-part, kunyari, yung part na yan. Di ba, 90 degrees yung intersections na yan. Medyo hindi obvious, no? Pero pag, yan, pag tinignan mo yan, pag maganda yung graph yan, 90 degrees yan. Sumampalataya lang tayo, no? Na 90 degrees yan. So, that's how orthogonal works. So, example number 2. Okay, so for our example number 3, let's solve for the, or let's find the orthogonal trajectory of this particular curve. XY is equal to C. Hindi siya yung inyong traditional conic section, no? Pero let's check using Desmos. Kasi minsan, para ma-visualize lang natin. So, ano kaya itsura niya? Let's say XY is equal to C. So, any constant will do. Let's say 10. Puntihan natin. 5 lang. Ayan. So, para siyang hyperbolic. Para siyang hyperbolic function, no? Pero nasa axis yung ano niya, no, yung tawag dito, yung asymptotes, no. So yan, asymptote siya diyan. So this is xy is equal to 5. Now our goal is to get the orthogonal trajectory of this. Sige. First, 'di ba, is we're going to differentiate, and that is equal to x dy plus y dx is equal to 0. So ano to, no? Parang nag-product rule ka lang dyan. X dy plus y dx is equal to c. Is equal to 0. So next step is kunin natin yung dy over dx. So that is dy x is equal to negative y dx. Okay? So therefore, yung dy over dx mo, pagpalitin mo lang yung pwesto, that is negative y over x. Okay? And since this is our slope ng family of curves, kailangan ko yung trajectory or yung orthogonal trajectory. So orthogonal. So ano to, no? Symbol lang for perpendicularity or orthogonal. So this is equal to negative reciprocal, that is x over y. Okay? So therefore, distribute lang natin para ma-integrate na natin at makuha yung family of curves. So that is equal to y dy is equal to x dx. Ayan. And kung mapapansin natin, this is variable separable lang. Ayan, no? Integrate mo lang. So this is equal to y squared over 2 is equal to x squared over 2. Don't forget your vitamin C kasi nag-integrate tayo. Bakit may over 2? Para mas madaling masimplify. So multiply ka lang ng 2 dyan para mawala. So therefore, our answer is y squared is equal to x squared plus c. So transpose natin para magandang tingnan, y squared minus x squared is equal to c. So ito yung orthogonal trajectories nung mukhang hyperbola kanina. So try natin i-graph ano kayang itsura niyan. Okay. Nasaan na yung graph natin? Okay, let's graph. So ano ulit siya? Aha. Y squared minus x squared is equal to c. So y squared minus x squared is equal to c. So 5 lang din gamitin natin. Ayan. So ganyan siya. Parang hyperbola lang din siya, pero opening upward and downward. And kung mapapansin ninyo, ayan. So ito yung makikita nyo na nag-orthogonal siya with respect to that. So again, no, dapat pag sinabi natin orthogonal trajectories, ikakat niya yung family of curves orthogonally or 90 degrees. Ayan. So, ayan siya. So, pwede naman i-try ko niya, 10. Tapos ito, 10 din. Dapat ganun din siya. Ayan. Same constant dapat kasi C. Okay? So, that's for number 3. Eto, example number 4. Paano kaya natin makuha orthogonal trajectories na to? Ngayon, let's try to visualize, no? Si cubic. Diba si cubic parang ano to, no? Ang cubic functions, ganyan yung itsura. So, para mas ma-visualize lang natin, takbo tayo kay Desmos. No? With the aid of Desmos, para ma-visualize lang din natin. So, ano ulit yun? Y is equal to cx cube. So, ycx cube, y is equal to, ang c natin, sabihin natin 10, ycx raised to 3. Ayan. Gawin natin 5 lang. Ganun din pala. Ayan, sige. Ayan. So, ganyan yung graph niya, di ba? Okay, let's solve. Paano kaya to? First is differentiate. So, ano yung differentiate niyan? Dy is equal to c quantity 3x square dx. Okay, next step is get dy over dx. So, that is dy over dx is equal to c multiplied by 3x square. Pero, ang problema natin, may constant, kailangan matanggal yan. Dito natin kukunin. So, c is equal to y over x cube. Okay? So, substitute lang natin yan dyan. Dy is equal to dx. Tapos, yung nakuha natin is, ano yun? Y over x cube times 3x square. So, kung mapapansin ninyo, magiging ano to? Dy over dx is equal to 3y over x. Kasi x cube yung baba, tas x square. So, yan na lang. So, next, let's get the orthogonal slope, negative x over 3y. Ayan na. Negative reciprocal lang. Next is you just multiply, cross multiply, para makita nyo, 3y dy is equal to negative x dx. Ayan. So basically, variable separable na naman yan agad. So just get the integral that is just equal to 3y squared over 2 is equal to negative x squared over 2 plus c over 2 natin para mawala again yung 2. So, multiply again ng 2 para mawala yung mga 2. 3y squared is equal to negative x squared plus c. So, transpose natin magiging x squared plus 3y squared is equal to c. Ayan. So, this is the orthogonal trajectory ng ating nakuhang family of curves. So, tama ba? 3. So far, so good. Sige nga, check natin yan. So, x squared plus 3y squared, no? Parang circle to, no? Is equal to, ano ulit yun? Is equal to c. So, x squared plus 3y squared is equal to c. Hindi, ellipse. Ellipse pala to, no? Yung mga ganito, ellipse. Is equal to c. So, 5 din gamitin natin. Ayan. So, papansin ninyo, ellipse siya. So, kapag ellipse, ang orthogonal trajectory niya is cubic. At yung cubic, ang orthogonal trajectory niya is ito. Ayan, oh, kita nyo ba? There. Ayan yung graph niya. Okay? Okay, example number 5. Let's try this one. Paano kaya ito? Worded problem naman. Find the parabolas of parabola symmetric with respect to the x-axis and the vertex at the origin. So, draw muna natin yan para kita lang natin. Gawa tayong Cartesian. Tapos sabi, family of parabola symmetric with respect to the x-axis and vertex at the origin. So dapat nandito yan. So either it is opening to the right or opening to the right, to the left, no? Dahil ang axis of symmetry daw is with respect sa x-axis. Ngayon, ang general or ang standard formula ng parabolas opening upward or to the right or to the left is equal to, dapat maalala nyo to, no? Y minus k squared, recall, no? 4a x minus h squared. Yan. So dapat medyo recall ng konting analytic geometry, no? Pero, ay, walang squared to. Yan, kasi parabola. So parabola, isa lang yung square, no? So ang palatandaan ko dito is kung saan siya, opening to the left or opening to the right, di ba? With respect sa y, no? Na opening to the left or opening to the right, edi dun ka mag-i-square kasi with respect sa y. Parang ganun. Ganun ko siya, kunyari, pag x square, di ba ang x square is opening upward or downward? So with respect sa x axis naman, okay? Ito naman kasi symmetry with respect. Okay? So, eh, ang origin daw ay 0, 0. Ay, ang origin. Ang vertex is at the origin or 0, 0. So, pwede ko na itong i-write as y squared is equal to 4ax. Kasi 0, 0. So, first step, differentiate natin to y dy. Kasi kailangan ko ng dy over dx is equal to 4a dx. Simplify, divided by 2, y dy is equal to 2a dx. Kunin natin yung dy over dx, that is equal to 2a over y. Kaso ang problema ko yung a. Saan ko kukunin yung a? Siyempre, dito na lang. So therefore, ang a ko is equal to y square all over 4x. Okay, ayan. Over 4x mo lang. So substitute niya lang yan dyan, magiging 2y multiplied by y square over 4x. So that is equal to y squared over y, that is just y, tapos 2 over 4, that is 2x. So therefore, yan yung bago nyong dy over dx. Eh, yan yung slope of the curve nung dy over d, nung family of curves. So let's get the orthogonal slope, which is negative reciprocal, negative 2x over y. Ayan, multiply nyo lang, cross multiply, then we integrate or we solve for the general solution. It's equal to y dy is equal to negative 2x dx. Integrate, integrate. That is equal to y squared over 2 is equal to negative 2x squared over 2 plus c over 2 para madaling simplify. Multiply nyo ng 2 para mawala yung 2. Cancel to, cancel to. So therefore, our answer is y squared is equal to negative 2x squared plus c. Transpose nyo, that will become 2x squared plus y squared is equal to constant. And that is the orthogonal trajectory ng parabolas opening to the right or opening to the left. No? Pero for the meantime, yung opening to the right lang muna. Ngayon, let's check kung ano itsura niyan. Ano itsura niyan? So, try natin. May mga try na akong graphs lang kanina. So, This is, then yung una muna ang family of curves. Ano yun? Opening to the right yung ginawa ko. No? So, y squared is equal to 4ax. So, y squared is equal to 4. Let's say ang 4 na, ang is 4x. No? Gawa tayo ng iba pa. Pwede pa. Actually, parang ito yung mga ginawa ko kanina. Pero may trinay lang din ako. Let's say, gawin natin 6. Pwede din yan. Or ano ba? Gawin natin 2. Yan. Tapos yung isa ay gawin natin 10. Ayan. Ayan siya. Ngayon, di ba sabi ang orthogonal natin is orthogonal trajectories or dapat pag-green up natin to, yung mga curves ay ikakat niya yung family of curves kanina nung parabola with respect to 90 degrees. So 2x squared plus y squared. So that is 2x squared plus y squared is equal to certain constant. Sabi natin 16. Ayan, three terms. Magawa pa tayo. Let's say 40. Any constant will do. Copy. Or let's say 100 para kita natin. Yan. Pakita natin. Yan. Kung mapapansin niyo yan, ito yung, ayan, kita nyo ba? Yan yung orthogonal parts niya or orthogonal cutting. Trajectory means yung itong family of curves natin will always be at perpendicular or orthogonal dun sa curve na trinatraject niya or trajectory. May word ba traject? Okay? And that's it. So you can try to explore other options or other examples, lalo na yung mga ganito, no? Yung mga worded problems, okay? So, ito si Kuya Mo Felix, no? Nagsasabi na, do not study until you get it right, study until you cannot get it wrong. Practice lang ng practice, practice lang ng practice para ma-develop ang ating mastery. Study hard, study smart, guys. See you in my next videos. Bye!